Believe it or not, socialization nowadays has become lesser personal unlike before where you interact and mingle with people in person. Physical contact is given and face-to-face conversations are very much preferred. The simple acquaintances become bond, then later turns into friendship, which could possibly lead into intimacy and deeper relationships, which, I think, is ideal and healthy. However, why is this becoming rare now? Over time, technology has brought us farther from that actual physical bond, since most of us has been so preoccupied with our studies and academic pursuits, as well as our profession, jobs, duties, work, or whatever may we regard it to as. Although I have to admit that technology did so much aid for convenience to us. Now, we have this social media running all over our phones, laptops, tablets, or whatever smart gadget there is, of which we believe to make all ends meet. Now, how does social media affect us? Is it helpful or destructive? Wikipedia defines social media as interactive computer-mediated technologies that facilitate the creation of sharing of information, ideas, career interests, and other forms of expression via virtual communities and networks, websites and applications that enable users to create and share content or to participate in social networking. Technology has been continuously upgrading, innovating smartphones that can make almost everything possible. With the help of the internet, any kind of information that you need, like entertainment, news reports, sports and recreation, and many others has been very accessible, making one very close to everything in just a swipe or a click. Distance is one gap that social media has remedied. Regardless of the place you are in, so long as you're in touch, even just with your smartphone, you can still reach your family and friends. The massive reach of social media has, somehow, helped retain and sustain any person's connectivity to people and to the world. Before, when life wasn't shaken yet by the COVID-19 pandemic crisis, a couple of hours spent in social media is still considerable. Now, we are but obliged to depend on it, which I would say is unhealthy. One of the downsides of this sudden societal transition, aside from we can no longer interact personally, is that health aspects might inevitably be compromised. Since the occurrence of this extremely unwanted pandemic, business establishments and micro-businesses were left without a choice but to close as soon as possible, letting them to make use of the online or the cyber world, particularly the social media sites, as their go-to outlets or mediums for advertising, promoting, buying, and selling products and other essential items. Given the situation, even the education was gravely affected. Students can no longer attend their classes the usual way, where you either walk or commute going to school to avoid virus infections. Alternative and flexible learning needs to be adapted for the students to still continue studying, having the students purchase their own laptop, tablet, if not, smartphone at the very least. This, unfortunately, would have to require students, even as young as a kindergarten, to face their gadgets for hours every day just to attend classes virtually. Also, the fact that students need to keep in touch with their classes, they will need to have social media accounts and online video conferencing platforms. Through that, their concerns can be addressed. Even the workers and employees, as much as possible, are encouraged to leave their workplaces and work from home. Well, this gives an employee perks of having a break from a stressful commuting daily and making time for the family. Generally, social media has been almost everybody's go-to option, whether it be work-related, academics, business-related, for without social media, one cannot access enough information or even online services going rampant these days. There are a lot of advantages social media can offer, but of course, negative effects won't easily be out of the picture. Even health could be at stake, most especially that we now are depending on social media to work, study, be entertained, informed, to play, to transact, and a lot more. Again, it all depends to the user on how he or she is going to use social media.